فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
ولذلك, as we said before, other people did write in this field, maybe not as a subject that stands like Mustalah al-Hadith. They had written subjects here and there. So inshallah ta'ala, I'm going to now mention the books in order. I'm going to mention the books that are written in Mustalah al-Hadith. And I'm going to mention them in order of the death of the authors and the order of the books and how they were written. The first book is the one I just mentioned, written by Al-Qadhi Abi Muhammad Al-Hassan ibn AbdulRahman ibn Khalad Ar-Ramahurmuzi. His book is called Al-Muhaddith Al-Fasil Bayn Al-Rawi Wal-Wa'i. Al-Muhaddith Al-Fasil بين الراوي والواعي. The book is called المحدث الفاصل بين الراوي والواعي. This book, the author رحمه المزيو, he died 360 هجرية رحمه الله تعالى. And If I'm not wrong, my mind does not trick me, I think that this book has been published by the tahqiq of Shaykh Tariq Iwadullahi. I know there's a previous tahqiq of Muhammad Ajaj. I know that. And I have that one. The tahqiq and what's tahqiq, huh? Yeah, the person who brought the manuscripts together, who worked on it, who put footnotes on it, that's called the tahqiq. The muhaqqiq before was Muhammad Ajjaj Al-Khatib. He did it when the Hijriya was 1391 Hijriya. He published his one. But I think recently, Tariq Iwadullahi, he brought out the book. I might be wrong if it's him or not, but it's one thick volume in which he brought it out on. The second book is Ma'rifatu Ulum al-Hadith. And it's written by Al-Hakim Abu Abdullah Muhammad ibn Abdullah al-Naysaburi. Al-Imam Hakim al-Naysaburi. Al-Imam Hakim al-Naysaburi died the year 450 Hijriya. He called his book Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith. Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith. And he died 450 Hijriya. The third book is Al-Mustakhraj li Abi Nu'aym Ahmad ibn Abdullah ibn Ahmad ibn Ishaq Al-Asbahani. Abu Nu'aym Al-Asbahani is enough for you to write. It's called Al-Mustakhraj. And this Mustakhraj is on the book of Ulum al-Hadith by Hakim. What does a mustakhraj mean? What does a mustakhraj actually mean? Mustakhraj means an author will come to a book. I will come to a book. And when I come to the book, I will come to these ahadith with a narration different to the narration of the author of this book. But I will come to him in his teacher or anyone above it. I will not narrate the book from him. I will either come with this, the author, for instance, I want to go to Kitab al-Nawawi. Al-Imam al-Nawawi's Kitab, Arba'in Nawawi. I will narrate those ahadith in Arba'in al-Nawawi, each hadith. Those hadith in there. So let's say, for example, who narrated the first hadith? Umar radiallahu anhu, right? Which book is it in? Is it Sahih al-Bukhari, right? Bukhari narrated it in his, what's the chain of Bukhari? Bukhari says, Hadithan al-Humaydi wa Abdullah ibn Zubayr. So Bukhari narrated this hadith from his teacher, Humaydi Abdullah ibn Zubayr. What I'm going to do is, this hadith is Sahih al-Bukhari, right? Okay, good. I'm going to narrate this hadith without having to hear on, my narration is not going to go through Bukhari. I'm going to meet Bukhari on his teacher. So Bukhari's teacher narrated it to Bukhari and another person. I'm going to use the other person's narration. Or I'm going to come to the book from anywhere within the chain as long as it's above the author of that book, as long as it's above Bukhari. That's what I'm doing, mustakhraj. And there are many benefits in mustakhrajat, but we're not going to speak about it now, inshaAllah ta'ala. Al-Imam Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani, who died the year 430 Hijriya, what he's trying to do is, he's trying to do that to the book Ma'rifatu Ulum al-Hadith, written by Hakim al-Nisaburi. Okay? Pay attention. Because Abu Nu'aym has a mustakhraj on Sahihain. Are you there? Abu Nu'aym, he has a mustakhraj on Sahihain. He did that to Bukhari al-Muslim. That's not this one here right now. This is al-mustakhraj on the kitab of al-Imam Hakim al-Nisaburi, Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith. And this kitab, al-Subhi al-Saburra'i, you mentioned, this kitab is makhtoot, the mustakhraj of Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani. It's in manuscript is present till today in Istanbul, Turkey. Somebody gets it and works on it and brings it out to the Muslims, his reward is with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So it's still not come out as a published book yet. Number four, Al-Kifayatu Fi Ilmi Riwaya. The fourth book is a kitab called Al-Kifaya Fi Ilmi Riwaya. And this kitab is written by who? Li Abi Bakr, Ahmad ibn Ali, ibn Thabit, Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi. We died the year 463 Hijriya. Al-Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi. His kitab is called Al-Kifaya Fi Ilmi Riwaya. Are we all together? Who is this? Al-Imam Khatib al-Baghdadi. These four books that I mentioned, Ibn Hajar mentions it and he speaks about it in his Nuzhatun Nadar, fi tawdih Nukhbatul-Fikr. Ibn Hajar talks about those four books. He says about the first one, written by Al-Hakim al-Nisaburi. He says about it, فَمِنْ أَوَّلِ مَنْ صَنَّفَ فِي ذَلِكَ الْقَاضِي أَبُو مُحَمَّدٍ أَرَّامَهُ الْمُزِيُّ فِي كِتَابِهِ الْمُحَدِّثِ الْفَاصِلِ لَكِنَّهُ لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبْ. He said from the first people who wrote this in the science of hadith is Al-Qadhi Abu Muhammad Ar-Ramahu al-Muziyu. He's from the early people who written it. But the problem with his book is لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبْ. مَا مَعَنَا لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبْ. What does it mean? لَمْ يَسْتَوْعِبْ means he has not brought the science and everything related to it from all of his corners. Meaning, he didn't do isti'ab. He did not bring everything that was needed to be spoken about in science of hadith. Okay, what's the second book? The kitab, Ma'rifatu Fi Ulum al-Hadith, written by who? Al-Hakim al-Nisaburi. He says, وَالْحَاكِمُ عَبِي عَبْدِ اللَّهِ النِّسَابُورِي لَكِنَّهُ لَمْ يُهَذِّبْ وَلَمْ يُرَتِّبْ. The problem with his one, on the other hand, Hafiz Mahajir says, is that he hasn't organized his one. لَمْ يُهَذِّبْ وَلَمْ يُرَتِّبْ. He didn't do tahdhib nor tartib of it. Meaning he hasn't organized it and put it in a nice organized, a very sequential manner. He didn't do it in that way. That's his problem. وَتَلَاهُ أَبُو نُعَيْمِ الْأَصْبَهَانِ فَعَمِلَ عَلَى كِتَابِ مُسْتَخْرَجًا وَأَبْقَى أَشْيَاءَ لِلْمُتَعَقِبِ. He said after him came Abu Nu'aym al-Asbahani and he did a mustakhraj. Ibn Hajr saying this. وَأَبْقَى أَشْيَاءَ لِلْمُتَعَقِبِ. And he left behind some things for a person to comment on. Meaning he left points for a person to hold him account for. Somebody could do ta'aqib on him. Are we all together on that? Then Hafidh ibn Hajr speaks about, he speaks about the kitab written by Khatib al-Baghdadi, which is al-kifayat fi ulum al-riwayah. He says, وَقَلَّ, it is very little. فَنٌ مِنْ فُنُونِ الْحَدِيثِ, it's very little that you find a science from the science of hadith. إِلَّا وَقَدْ صَنَّفَ فِيهِ كِتَابًا مُفْرَدًا. Except that Khatib al-Baghdadi has written an independent book in it. Khatib al-Baghdadi, rahimahullah, he has broken down the science of hadith and each issue of hadith, he wrote a book on it. Are you looking for mudraj? He wrote a hadith on it. Are you with me, brothers? Are you looking for the adab of the narrator and how he, the manner in which he should narrate a hadith? He wrote a book on it. He broke down the books of hadith and he wrote independently. And he also authored one that's comprehensive. He's got one that's comprehensive, which is called Al-Kifayah fi Ilm al-Riwayah. And then he has ones that are independent in each of it. Are we all together on that? And so I advise you all to read a book written by Ustadh Yusuf Al-Ash, rahimahullah, hafidhahullah. He has wrote a book called Al-Khatib al-Baghdadi Mu'arrikhu Baghdada wa Muhadithuha. Khatib al-Baghdadi, the historian of Baghdad and its Muhadith, his scholar of Hadith, written by Ustadh Yusuf Al-Ashim. He talks very well, gives a good understanding who Khatib al-Baghdadi is. The next kitab is Al-Ilma' ila ma'rifati usul al-riwayati wa taqyid al-sama'. It's the fifth book. This kitab is written by Al-Qadi Abu al-Fadl Iyad ibn Musa ibn Iyad al-Yahsubi. You all hear Qadi Iyad, right? Who wrote the kitab al-Shifa. Al-Yahsubi, rahimahullah. Qadi Iyad, he died when the Islamic history was 554 Hijriah. He wrote a kitab called Al-Ilma' ila ma'rifatu al-usul al-riwayati wa taqid al-sima'. Ustad Sayyid Saqar, he done tahqiq of the book. And it's matbu' mutadawal. You can find it. Number six is مَا لَا يَسْعُ الْمُحَدِّثُ جَهْلَهُ. This kitab, مَا لَا يَسْعُ الْمُحَدِّثُ جَهْلَهُ, that which a muhaddith should not be ignorant of. This kitab is written by Abi Hafs Umar ibn Abd al-Majid Al-Mayanaji or Al-Mayanashi. You can say it with a jeem and you can say it with a sheen. This kitab, it has the tahqiq and the works. First of all, the author died 570-80 Hijriah. Abi Hafs Al-Mayanaji, Abi Al-Mayanashi, he died what? He died 580 Hijriah. And the kitab, the tahqiq was done by Ustadh Subhi As-Sumarra'i. Ustadh Subhi As-Samarra'iyu. As-Samarra'iyu. I will write inshallah ta'ala on the board later all the names of the books bi-idhnillahi al-kareem. Al-Ustadh Subhi As-Samarra'iyu. He done tahqiq on the kitab. My sheikh, he once said that this book does not deserve to be bought. It's a waste of money. And there's no value in it. Because the mistakes that are in this book is excessive, it's too much. They're severe mistakes, severe mistakes. So I've never ever managed to personally buy one of those books. I've read through it on the internet, but I never ever wanted to buy it. The other one is, the seventh book is Ulum al-Hadith. And I want you to, if you haven't memorized all the other ones that I mentioned before, please just remember this one then. Ulum al-Hadith is also well known as Muqaddimah ibn al-Salah. It's also well known as what? Muqaddimah ibn al-Salah. Ulum al-Hadith ama Muqaddimah ibn al-Salah is written by Taqiyuddin Abi Amr Uthman ibn al-Salah al-Shafi'iyu. Ibn al-Salah al-Shafi'i. Ulum al-Hadith is written by who? Ulum al-Hadith is written by Ibn al-Salah. This kitab has so many shuruh explanations on it. One of the scholars that done sharah on it is Zayruddin al-Iraqi. Zayruddin al-Iraqi has a sharah on it, al-Taqeed, which he explains the kitab Ulum al-Hadith. Zayruddin al-Iraqi, who is the teacher of who? Ibn Hajar. And he also made a poetry of it. He also did nazm of it, poetry. This kitab, Ulum al-Hadith. Which nazm did he do? The one that's known as what? It's known as Alfiyat al-Iraqi. But the lengthy name of it is called what? Al-Tabsiratu wa-Tadhkira. Written by who? Zainuddin al-Iraqi. He made it into a poetry. The kitab written by Ibn al-Salah, he explained it, and then he turned it into a poetry. It also got summarized. The book got summarized. By who? By Ibn Kathir. Ibn Kathir's Ikhtisar Ulum al-Hadith is a summary of Ulum al-Hadith by... It's a summary of the Kitab Ulum al-Hadith written by Ibn Salah. So you can see the people who came together on this book are who? Mountains. And also, Nukat has been put on it. Nukat here means istidrakat with shuruh al-hawashi. Meaning explanation, any mistakes, any disagreement has been put on it by none other than Hafidh Ibn Hajar. Ibn Hajar has a Nukat ala Ibn Salah. He wrote up till Maqbul. He wrote until what? Maqlub. Ibn Hajar, and he died. And the kitab is, it's published, it's mutadawal, and it's done with the tahqiq of Al-Shaykh Rabi' ibn Hadi al-Madkhali. He is the one who done tahqiq of the kitab. Also recently, Mahir Yasin al-Fahl also worked on the Nukat ala ibn Salah, and he brought it out, the Ibn Hajar's one. So the scholars, they done tawaf, full tawaf, and i'tikaf around the book of Ibn Salah, rahimahullah ta'ala. When I say tawaf, I don't literally mean they went around it. I just mean they came to the book from different angles. Whether it be explaining it, whether it be what? Turning it into a poetry, whether it be summarizing the book, whether it be putting istidrak on the book, any correcting the book and any mistakes that are on it. The point of the matter is Laftatul Anvar al-Ulama, the eyes and the looking and the direction which the eyes of the scholars of Hadith went towards was the kitab written by Ibn Salah. People just stood over that. Rather, today it's very hard that anybody will tell you that they've even read Ulum al-Hadith written, Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith written by who? By Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi, for instance. Or Kifaya, written by Khatib al-Baghdadi, or you know, Al-Ilma' written by Qadi Iyad al-Yahsubi rahimahullah, or Abu Nu'aym Mustakhraj on Abu Abdullah al-Hakim al-Naysaburi's Ma'rifat Ulum al-Hadith. Rarely would somebody tell you. But majority of the people who studied science of Hadith, they will tell you they studied the works of Ibn Salah. And Ibn Salah's kitab, it was a book he started to dictate. It was a dictation. It was imla. He was dictating it to these students, and he was organizing it, and he was preparing it, and he was putting it together. And it's a book that is full of so many benefits. Also, number 8 is Al-Irshad. Al-Irshad is a summary of Muqaddimah ibn Salah. Who is it? Wrote it? Al-Imam al-Nawawi, Abu Zakariya, Muhyiddin ibn Sharaf al-Nawawi, who died in the year 676. Nawawi summarized in this book, he summarized the Muqaddim of Ibn Salah. And what did he do? He then, brothers and sisters, are we together? He then summarized the Irshad again. Nawawi himself. And he called it At-Taqrib wa At-Taysir fi Ma'rifati Sunan al-Bashir al-Nadir. And the Tadrib al-Rawi of Suyuti. Jalaluddin al-Suyuti is Tadrib al-Rawi that you always hear about. The Tadrib al-Rawi is taken from, it's taken from the Taqrib wa Taysir fi Ma'rifati Sunan al-Bashir al-Nadir by Al-Imam al-Nawawi rahimahullah ta'ala. The 9th kitab that's also out there is called Al-Qasidatul Gharamiyya. Al-Qasidatul Gharamiyya. And it's written by Shihabuddin Abil Abbas Ahmed Ibn Farhin Al-Ishbili, who died in 699 Hijriah. It's called Qasidatul Gharamiyya. There are many scholars who've explained it, the Qasida. And it is مطبوع متداول. And he called it القصيدة الغرامية في مصطلح خير البرية. And the good thing about this kitab, and the funny thing about it, is that this book is a poetry on hadith, right? Yeah? But what it is done is that he's not speaking about hadith. He's talking about normal things, and he's using a hadith terms to make you to understand. The 10th is al-iqtirah fi bayan al-istilah wa ma udhifa ila dhalika min al-ahadith al-ma'dudah min as-sihah, which is in summary only known as الاقتراح في بيان الاصطلاح. It's called الاقتراح في بيان الاصطلاح. This kitab is written by Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid, Taqiyuddin Muhammad ibn Ali ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid. And this kitab, الاقتراح by Ibn al-Daqiq al-Eid, is not going in accordance to any books that he summarized it from or not. And he died the year 702 Hijriah. The 11th book is Al-Manhal al-Rawiyyu fi Mukhtasar Ulum al-Hadith al-Nabawi, and it is written by Badruddin Muhammad ibn Ibrahim ibn Jama'ah, who died the year 733 Hijriah. Also, another kitab called Al-Khulasa fi Usul al-Hadith, and it's written by Sharifuddin al-Tibi, who died the year 743. You have the kitab Al-Muqidah fi Ilmi Mustalah al-Hadith, written by Al-Imam al-Dhahabi, Shamsuddin Muhammad ibn Ahmed al-Dhahabi. And the Muqidah is a summary of Al-Iqtirah of Ibn Daqiq al-Eid. The Muqidah of Al-Imam al-Dhahabi is a what? The Muqidah of Al-Imam al-Dhahabi rahimahullah is actually a summary of the Iqtirah fi Bayan al-Istilah wa ma udhifa ila dhalika min al-ahadith al-ma'dudati min al-sihah written by Ibn Daqiq al-Eid. And Al-Imam al-Dhahabi died the year 748 Hijriah. Then we also have the 14th book, which is the Ikhtisar Ulum al-Hadith, written by Abil Fida Imaduddin Ismail ibn Umar ibn Kathir rahimahullah, who died the year 774 Hijriah. He wrote Ikhtisar Ulum al-Hadith, where he summarized which book? The Ulum al-Hadith by Imam Ibn Salah rahimahullah ta'ala. Number 15 is Mahasin al-Istilah fi Tadmini Kitab Ibn Salah, and this is written by Abi Hafs Umar ibn Raslan al-Bulqini, al-Bulqini, however way you want to say it. And he died the year 805 Hijriah. You also have the kitab, which I already mentioned before, and it's called At-Taqyid wal-Idah, which is a sharah of Muqaddimah ibn Salah, and it's written by who? Zainuddin AbdulRahim ibn al-Husayn al-Iraqi, rahimahullah, who died the year 806 Hijriah, and he's the teacher of who? Ibn Hajar, rahimahullah ta'ala. We also have the kitab Nazm al-Durar fi Ilm al-Athar, which is also known as a tafsir wa tadhkira, as I mentioned before, written by Iraqi, it's called Alfiyat al-Iraqi. We also have the Sharah of Alfiyat al-Iraqi. The Sharah of Alfiyat al-Iraqi, which is Fath al-Mughith bi Sharh Alfiyat al-Hadith, written by Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi rahimahullah ta'ala. Al-Imam al-Sakhawi wrote Fath al-Mughith. And last but not least, we have the last book, which is Al-Mukhtasar fi Usul al-Hadith, and it's written by Al-Hasan ibn Ali ibn Ali al-Jurjani, who died the year 812 Hijriah. And there are many other books that are written. If you were to count, you could reach up to 100. You could reach up to a what? These are the most prominent ones. They're the most famous and well-known ones. But my advice to my beloved brothers and sisters is, if anybody wants to study Mustalah al-Hadith and they truly want to understand it, what is the one book that I can say would suffice you, would give you a strong understanding of Mustalah al-Hadith, and you could have a proper understanding? It is the kitab Fath al-Mughith, which is a sharh of Alfiyat al-Iraqi, written by Shamsuddin al-Sakhawi. Fath al-Mughith. If you buy the taba'a of Dar al-Minhaj, brothers and sisters, Maktabat al-Minhaj is taba'a, if you buy it, okay, that book will suffice you from all of the other books I mentioned. And then if you memorize with it Alfiyatul Iraqi, if you memorize the Alfiyah itself, the 1,000 lines of poetry written in this field, and you take the explanation of it straight away from the Fath al-Mughith of Sakhawi, you are going to be strong in knowing the science of Hadith. You are strong in Mustalah al-Hadith. You can also, another book that's also equivalent to it, inshallah ta'ala, and it's of that caliber, bi'idhnillah al-kareem, is the kitab written by Suyuti, Jalaluddin Suyuti, and it's called Tadrib al-Rawi. And I said to you, Tadrib al-Rawi is from the book which? التقريب والتيسير في سنن البشير النذير. By who? النووي رحمه الله تعالى. That's the book in which he's commenting on and he's explaining. So pay attention here, my beloved brothers and sisters. Those two, any of those two that you take, they're very good. Whether you go for what? Whether you go for Fathul Mughith by Suyuti, Fathul Mughith by Sakhawi, or you go with what? Tadrib al-Rawi written by As-Suyuti. And they hated each other. The two authors, Sakhawi and Suyuti, they met each other. There was a rivalry between the two of them consistently. Who was more knowledgeable between the two of them? Suyuti rahimahullah ta'ala. But Sakhawi was a bit older than Suyuti. Huh? Sakhawi was older. Because Sakhawi took knowledge from who? Ibn Hajar. Suyuti met Ibn Hajar. He saw him as a child. He walked in to his gathering. Rather, Suyuti's father brought him to Ibn Hajar as a kid and said, make dua for my son. So Suyuti was made dua for by Ibn Hajar. Huh? Suyuti met him. And they all were together in Egypt. Ibn Hajar was in Egypt. Suyuti was in Egypt. And Sakhawi was in Egypt.